hear the good news of Jesus as it is recorded in the Gospel according to John, the 14th chapter, verses 8 to 17 and 25 to 27.
Glory to Christ our Savior.
Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that we will be enough for us. Jesus answered, Don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me? The word I say to you are not just my own, rather it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. Or at least believe on the evidence of the miracles themselves. I tell you the truth. Anyone who has faith in me will do what I have been doing. He will do even greater things than these, because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me of anything in my name, and I'll do it. If you love me, you will obey what I command. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth. The world cannot accept him, because it is neither sees him nor know him, but you know him. For he lives with you and will be with you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Then we read from 25 to 27. All these things I have spoken while I'm still with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid. Word of the Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Now, I must confess that the last 2 weeks I forgot to greet the family at home. And so today I woke up and said, Maake, remember the family at home. Our reading was from Acts of the Apostle, chapter 2, 1 through 21, and Romans in the Epistle, chapter 8, 14 to 17, and the Gospel of John, 14, verse 8 to 17, 25 to 27. Good morning. A birthday of the church. 2022. Now, if I was a good singer, I was going to ask us, let's sing Happy Birthday to the Church. But sing it in your heart, because it was on this day, 2022, when they gathered together in the city of Jerusalem. They were instructed and commanded to stay there until the power of the Holy Spirit comes upon them. And on that day of birthday, they received such a gift of the power of the Holy Spirit. This is a gift that has sustained the church for centuries. It happened, and it can still happen to us today. They never quite understood him, but they believed that he was the Messiah, the King of the Jews. Now our King to all the world. Philip is asking because he was not sure where he was going. And so Jesus began to unpack the beauty of life. I and the Father are one. So if you know me, you know the Father. Because the Father has sent me so that I may reveal his power among you. The commandment of staying in Jerusalem was so that they could be one. In the prayer of last week, 17, that they may be one as you and I are one. Today's prayer is that if you know me, you know the Father. It's a preparation. You will receive the power of the Holy Spirit coming upon you. And then you will move from Jerusalem into the utter parts of the world to preach the word, that the world may come to know the Father through you and Jesus Christ as Lord, Lord of the universe. That's the message we received before the birthday of the church, that we stay together, we worship together, we lift God's grace up to the world until the power pours upon us, so that when it pours upon us, it then sends us to the world. You cannot be a Christian when you don't pass on the gift that was given to you, the Spirit of grace. The Nazarene, the carpenter, the ordinary person is now commanding and is asking them, the 12, to obey his commandment, to believe in the commandment, and to act out that commandment by loving others so that they may come to know that Jesus Christ is Lord, Lord of the universe. Happy birthday to the church. Sometimes this church is persecuted. Sometimes it goes underground. But the power of the Holy Spirit always sustains this church, whether it goes through the turmoils. For Jesus Christ is Lord and Lord of the universe. It can happen to us too, that we may stand through the tumults, We may go through corruptions. We may go through anger. We may be dissatisfied with what life is unfolding, but the power of the Holy Spirit never leaves us, will always journey with us until that time that Jesus Christ come back again. I need to tell the Methodists that John Wesley was fighting with this power of the Holy Spirit, even though you think he was great. He did not even want to go and preach. He refused the preaching. And the movement of this power in 18th century in England became a worldwide movement of the Holy Spirit. It is estimated that throughout the world today, there are over 70 million people whose churches are worshiping God. And the greatest among these continents is the continent of Africa that worship God Almighty. But the question is to ask, why then this continent that is full of Christians has so many disasters, so many difficulties? Has God forsaken us? Has the power of the Holy Spirit left us? Preaching the word. Sometimes you may not be gifted in preaching the word, but your presence among those that live with you, they would feel the presence of the power of the Holy Spirit in the actions that you do. I like visiting supermarkets. I don't know if, but I always visit it when there are only specials. You know, this time. Yeah, you've got a budget, you know. You've got to budget. You don't just buy. I mean, fish oil has moved from 47 to 100. So God is giving you a mind to budget. But I like visiting that not to buy fish oil, but just to greet the tellers. And I say, good morning. He says, morning. I say, wow. You must be born on Monday when God was slow. And then she smiles. And I say, I was born on Wednesday. And how are you and how's the family? And my neighbors at the back would say, come on, move on. We want to pay too. And then I say, Jesus loves you when I take my pockets. That's the gift I have. What gift do you have of passing the power of the Holy Spirit to those who may not know him? You've got to realize that we took God out of the schools. There is a generation that is growing without knowing Jesus. When I grew up, every morning, our teachers stood up. We sang hymns. They read the scriptures. They blessed us. And we went into classrooms. When afternoon comes and the school was closing, the teacher who was in the class prayed for us. Our children do not have that. We're having children who may not know the word of the Lord. Some of them will only come because we grandparents ask that the children must be baptized. How are we going to nurture the generation that may live without Jesus Christ? How would we pass on this gift that you and I have received from our grandparents, from our parents, from our preachers, from our teachers, from our neighbors who loved us so dearly? Don't we have the responsibility of passing on the gift that was received on the birthday of the church, the gift of the Holy Spirit? Now, this power of the Holy Spirit has three connotations of words that we carry as we go to the world. Peace, of the Lord be with you. So we carry peace, not of our own, but of the Lord Jesus Christ, that when we come among the presence of those who quarrel, the peace of Jesus Christ may surround all of us. Second connotation is, obey my commandments. Therefore, you become under the authority of Jesus Christ, and Jesus directs you as to what you should say. And the last word is, love one another. Oh, that's too difficult. It's very difficult to love your friend, the enemy. But God will always send the friend, the enemy, so that you are challenged whether you would say peace be upon you. Believe in Jesus, which gives us the anchor of faith. The Father and I are one. So if you believe in Jesus, you are one with Christ and connected to the Father, and the power of the Holy Spirit will pour down on you and shares the beauty of life in your life. Yes, Peter standing, preaching the word, and the first fruits of the power of the gift of the Holy Spirit makes 120 people believe. They were baptized, preaching to 3,000. The world began moving along. Happy birthday, Church of Jesus Christ. Happy birthday. In every church in Pentecost, dunamis, the power is always with us. It's not selective. It only receives and pour down its blessing upon those who believe and love the church. Ascension was a holiday in our country. It is removed. The discussion that is going on in Parliament is that Christians have too many holidays. And yet on Christmas, they take a holiday and rejoice that they have a holiday, and they forget that it is Christ Jesus' day. So we have to pray hard that some of these symbols of the church may not be removed as long as we live. We may not be able to articulate and speak to them, but we have the power of vote. We have that power. If you're frightened about voting, you have the power of kneeling down and talk to Jesus. Sometimes, you know, as a Scottish, you have to be like a Xhosa man. Xhosa, when they speak to God, they direct God. So you need to articulate, God, I am getting tired of you being taken out of the schools, or you being taken out of the church. Come, power of the Holy Spirit, use us so that we may fight the battle with the power of the Holy Spirit, that they may know that you are God, King of the universe. They're talking about Easter. Actually, they have changed. We used to have Rand Easter Show, you remember? They no longer call it Rand Easter Show because it was praising God Almighty. That is the problem we are facing today. I want to share with you the story of a father in Texas. One of the children was killed 3 days before her birthday, 10th birthday. And this is a memory of how the father remembers Eli. Iligashia was one of the 19 children murdered in elementary, Robb Elementary in Texas. She died about a week before her 10th birthday. And the father placed in WhatsApp three of the pictures that he took, one in January, the other in March, and the last one was in May. And then he writes, "Oh, Elise, I love you, baby girl. I love the way you prayed in our home. And when you prayed, the Spirit of grace poured upon me." This is a father being nurtured by this child. But on that day, Elise prayed this prayer. "Hey guys," he's saying to the students in the classroom with her, 23 of them. "Hey guys, I just wanted to give you a little catch up about Jesus. He died for all of us, whether you believe it or not. So when we die, we will be up there with him in my room with him." What a beauty. What a beauty. How do your grandchildren pray? Do you teach them how to pray? I remember one time we were visiting friends in Florida, USA, and Seppo was a little girl, very, very small. And we were talking and we started eating without praying. And she says, no, we did not pray. We said, okay, pray. And he says, "God Almighty, we pray for the food in the stomach and the one that we're going to do, amen." It's the direction of God Almighty. When you teach them how to pray, it is a gift that can never part from them. Even when Alzheimer's come in, I have sat with old women and men in Worsleywood, and Alzheimer's will come. But the beauty that I found in them, that when we sang their favorite tunes, the mind came back and they recognized their children. This gift, it's a gift that is given to us. It is a gift that can never part, but it needs to be nurtured with hymns. It needs to be nurtured with prayer. It needs to be nurtured with fellowship. There are people now who worship through the television. It's something better. But you also need the fellowship of the church so that you may grow in stature and in love. I chose the hymn after this. "O Lord, my God, when I'm in awesome wonder." The story behind this great Thou Art song was written by Stuart Hines, a British Methodist missionary who was in Ukraine in 1931 in that part of the Russian-speaking people. And he heard the Russians always talking about, "O Stored God, O great God." Every sentence had a great God in them. So Heinz began translating the German words, and he began writing this song that has lived for some years. He then began going home when there was famine and the Second World War came around. He was placed back home in Britain, in Somerset. He continued ministering to the Polish people in Britain, and he began writing the third stanza of that song. And he began unfolding the beauty of God that was in him to share it with the world. He remembered writing on the afternoon, "Then sings my soul, my Savior, God to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art!" And this song was then published in the 40s, and we sing it to live God Almighty. My plea to you, St. John's, is that when we live the premises, that they may see Jesus in us. The world is lacking love, that we may love. I normally do not give money to the people who stand at the traffic light until I ask them their names. Now, I know you cannot do this. I tell them, "I want to give you something, but you must know that I get a stipend and not a salary." And the people pray for the money they give. If I give you, you take drugs, you will meet the Lord that you don't know. Then I give him, I move on. It should not be guilt that forces you to give them. But always tell them, "This is the gift that God has given me. I'm going to give you this gift, but promise me you would use it well." May God of mercy, God of peace sustain you until we meet again. This may be your last worship. I don't know. God may call you to glory. And when you enter into the glory to meet those beloved in your family, always sing, "How great thou art." Let's come on, Doc. Let's sing that. "How great thou art, O Lord, my God." Let's sing. Let's sing that song. Let's lift our voices. "Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee." Are we ready? My soul for happy birthday to the Church of Jesus Christ. Then sings my soul, my Savior, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And sing my soul, my Savior, now affirm our faith to this great God Almighty. We believe in God, creator of all that has been made, the parent of the whole creation. We believe in God, savior of all that has fallen, the restorer of the broken world. We believe in God, the life of all that lives, the love and the binds that things together in the family of God. Amen. Amen.